Hi, welcome to this class of module 5, hemodialysis and lithotripsy. So what do you mean by hemodialysis? If a person's kidney is not working properly, then his blood will contain lots of impurities like urea, potassium, sodium, etc., which should be disposed through urine. And these urines are being produced in your kidney. So if kidney is not functioning properly, then the waste material from the blood will not be excreted through your excretory organs. So in this typical condition, what we do? We used to dialyze a person in a week twice or thrice. So what do you mean by dialysis? Dialysis is a process of purifying the blood of a person whose kidneys are not working normally. Hemodialysis is that procedure helps control blood pressure, balance important minerals such as potassium, sodium, calcium in your blood. That is, if sodium content is more, it should not be more or it should not be lesser. Potassium content should not be more or lesser. It should be balanced. If the waste material such as sodium, potassium, if it should be excreted through your excretory organs, then if it is not done, then this waste material will build up inside your body and it will cause imbalance to your body. It will cause toxic effect to your body. So this is why this waste materials which is produced from your cells should be disposed effectively. So it's a medical procedure. So dialysis is a medical procedure used to purify the blood by use of a dialyzer. By use of a dialyzer, we used to purify the blood. A machine that functions as an artificial kidney. So a dialyzer will function as an artificial kidney. The end goal of the purification process is to restore the electrolyte balance within the body despite kidney's inability to function optimally. If the kidney is not working optimally, then also we are able to restore the electrolyte balance. So how it is done? So you can see a pictorial representation. So you can see one green arrow towards a patient and a blue arrow from the patient to the hemodialysis. So this green arrow is from your artery, and blue arrow is from your artery and green arrow is towards the veins. So what happens? The blood will be taken from this person through this artery and it will be fed to the blood pump, then to the dialyzer. After the dialyzer, the blood is purified and purified blood is fed to the vein. So we see how the dialysis will work. So you can see here the blood removed for dialysis through artery. So the blood will flow through the arterial pressure monitor. So from that, the blood is pumped through the dialyzer inflow pressure monitor. So there it will monitor the dialyzer pressure. So the blood will be pumped through the roller pump that I discussed in day before class. And from there, it consists of heparin pump. So this heparin pump will be provided to avoid the clotting in the blood. So you can see that the blood will clot very early. After 1 or 2 minutes, if the blood is left into the atmosphere, it will try to clot. So in order to avoid that one, we use anticoagulant injection. So that is being fed to here, and this anticoagulant injection prevents the blood from clotting. and it being fed to the, you can see the dialyzer. From the dialyzer filter, the dialyzer will absorb. It consists of a semi permeable membrane. This semi permeable membrane allows only the waste material such as the urea, sodium, potassium, which is being there in the blood. It absorbs that only, and the blood cells will be fed to the blood cells are easily fed to the blood venous pressure monitor. Then from the venous pressure monitor, the air tap and air detector is there. Why? Because the blood is being fed to this pipe. If any air is there, it will remove that air and it will then directly feed to the filtered blood return to the body. So this is how the block diagram of hemodialysis, it is being asked in your examination frequently. So now we see the working of a dialyzer. So how the dialyzer will work? So you can see that dialyzer, so it is work on the principle of diffusion. So the bloodstream and dialysis fluid. So bloodstream consists of metabolic toxins, urea, small proteins, etc., and blood cells. So the blood cells should not diffuse into the dialysis fluid. Only the waste material such as water molecules, electrolytes like sodium, magnesium, and urea, etc., should diffuse into the dialysis fluid. So this is that dialyzer membrane. So dialyzer consists of lots of dialyzer membrane. So like that, the dialyzer membrane will purify the, it will take the waste material from the blood and it will purify the blood. So you can see the dialyzer is a large canister containing thousands of small fibers through which your blood is passed. The dialysis solution blood is passed. The dialysis solution, the cleansing fluid, is pumped around these fibers. The fibers allow waste and extra fluid to pass from your blood into the solution. The fibers allows the waste and extra fluid to pass from your blood into the solution, which carries them away. The dialyzer is sometimes called as artificial kidney. So this is sometimes called as artificial kidney. So we can see in deep depth, blood will be inlet and blood outlet. The inlet blood consists of lots of impurities and outlet blood is a pure blood and is a head and the solution outlet. So you can see a solution outlet and solution inlet. So this solution is a dialyzer solution, and you can see a fibers, and though this will be consist of lots of fiber, it is semi permeable membrane fibers. These fibers will do the actual work here. It will filter the waste materials from the blood, and this waste material is being absorbed by the solution outlet, and it is being solution outlet consisting all the waste materials in your blood. See, this is how the small block diagram telling the working of your dialyzer. So you can see a water and metering pump and dialysate concentrate and metering pump. So the dialysate and water is being mixed up and in a mixing chamber, and it is pumped to the exchange chamber of dialysate. So exchange pump means it is pumped to the solution inlet. To the solution inlet, it consists of water metering pump and dialysate concentrate. So this water and dialysis concentrate both will be mixed and it is pumped to the solution inlet. So this is what, so mixing chamber pump and to the exchange chamber dialysate. So in this exchange chamber, it consists of membrane, and this from this blood, the from the blood, the waste material will be absorbed by the exchange chamber dialysate solution. And so you can see the waste here, and you can see the arterial blood is being pumped through a roller pump through, and the blood will be inlet to the dialyzer, and the outer blood will go to the venous blood. So you can I think you got the idea how the dialyzer work. Dialysate delivery system in this unit mixes dialysate from a concentrate before pumping it through the exchange chamber. So this exchange chamber is this one. Is this one. This is that exchange chamber. Okay. So now we see about the lithotripsy. So lithotripsy is also connected to your kidney. Lithotripsy is a procedure that uses shock waves to break up stones in the kidney and parts of the urethra tube that carries the urine from your kidneys to your bladder. After the procedure, the tiny pieces of stones pass out of your body in your urine. So this is how we can see in the kidney there is some problem related to stone formation. Stone formation is mainly is due to that if a person consumes lots of salt and calcium rich food, he consumes lots of calcium rich food, then the sodium, the calcium will be segregated in your kidney and it forms a stone here. So this stone is being break up using ultrasound shock waves. So this ultrasound shock waves turns this stone into a small pieces that can be easily passed through the urethra. From the urethra it is being passed through urine. So lithotripsy, a probe is guided under x-ray fluoroscopy through a small incision into the location of the kidney stone. Either the mechanical shock waves are produced at the tip of the probe by a controlled electric discharge spark, or probe contains an ultrasonic transducer that produces ultrasonic waves. So that is, consider a transducer contains an ultrasonic transducer. It produces a shock wave. This shock wave is fed to the body where your kidney is there. Each of these forms of energy is used to break up the kidney stone so that it can withdraw in pieces through the probe guide elements or can be allowed to pass through the urinary tract. So this is how the x-ray detector, water is there and the person is put to sit in this chamber and the high intensity x-ray beam is being passed and we can see the stone is broke up into a small particles. Shock wave, a biplane x-ray apparatus is used to make sure that stone is at focal point of spark generated shock waves from a ellipsoidal reflector. So the reflector will reflect the intensified beam. The high intensified beam is fed to the stone and then it is reflected back to reflector. The reflector will reflect once again that beam and making sure that the stone is fully bent into pieces. So what are the advantages of lithotripsy? The advantage of lithotripsy is no lengthy hospital stays. So in morning you can go and in the evening you can get out with cleaning your stones from your kidney. So no incisions, there is no needles are being inserted inside your body, no surgery, no lengthy recovery periods, so you can be recovered with 1 or 2 days. So the main disadvantage is some discomfort is there while passing the urine. So for passing sand like particles in urine for few days, so it causes some discomfort. The medicine to prevent infection. So if any infection is there, so once this stone passes through the urethra to the bladder, then to the urine, so then stone can cause some scratches in your urethra. So in order to avoid that, due to the scratches, some blood may spurt in the urethra. So in order to avoid that one, we use an antibiotics or a medicine to prevent the infections. Okay, fine. Thank you. I think you got the idea of hemodialysis and lithotripsy. Hemodialysis means the purifying the blood through a dialyzer. Lithotripsy means if your kidney is having any stone, then making it into small pieces through shock waves, ultrasonic shock waves or X-ray waves. Fine.